Now we're going to take a look at the heart of the building, the sanctuary, where everything is focused. And the altar of sacrifice is located right here. And it's almost nearly on the cross axis. It's just ever so slightly set back from the transverse axis. The altar is about 4 feet 6 by 10 feet. And it's elevated on this platform right here, one step above the main sanctuary. Right near the northeast crossing pier right here is the cathedral, the chair of the bishop. And on the southeast side is the ambo. It's also elevated up a couple of steps where, of course, the scriptures are proclaimed. And notice that the main sanctuary is elevated 4 steps above the nave floor. There's one step right here, and then 3 additional risers to get you up onto the main platform. There's an altar rail right in here and here that serves to delineate the sanctuary from the nave. And then I mentioned earlier, elevated even above the main sanctuary platform is the tabernacle, which is right here. And it's set within this shrine of columns that has a hemispheric apse above it, hemispheric dome. Also back in this area is the ramp for persons with physical handicaps. And some seating for the additional ministers. So this is how it's going to look from the nave. Of course, our main focus is on the altar of sacrifice right here, and carved into the face of it is the ancient Christogram, IHS, which is in recognition of the cathedral's dedication to the Holy Name of Jesus. Here's the cathedral, and it's rendered in the same materials and expression as the altar, and on the right is the ambo. The elevated platform with the tabernacle is right here, and this is that setting that it's within with its dome. And I'll just mention that the inspiration from this is drawn from the book of Revelation, chapters 1 and 2, where the evangelist describes the vision that he has of heaven. And these 24 columns represent the 12 elders and the 12 apostles that are dressed in white with golden crowns, and these 7 decorative lighting fixtures represent the 7 burning torches, and the 4 living creatures are going to be represented in these panels here. And the preliminary color inspiration is drawn from the work of Bernini at San Tommaso de Villanova at Castel Gandolfo. This illustration is an endeavor to convey to you the scale of the space and the relationship of the sanctuary and its location underneath the dome. And notice that the dome is directly above the sanctuary here. And it's a really significant feature of your cathedral. The word dome finds its origin in the Latin word domus, which means home. So this is the home of the diocese. It's where you will gather in union with the whole church and under the leadership of the bishop to encounter our Lord in the word and in the sacrament. So the dome reaches up above the assembly, and through it, the sunlight permeates down and illuminates the sanctuary directly below it, and it's an architectural expression of the union of heaven and earth.